We've been able to eradicate white polioviruses in Africa. I cannot imagine how Nigeria could have ever eradicated polio without the emergency operation centers. The polio EOCs now support COVID-19 outbreak response.
My name is Dr. Faisal Shuaib. I am the Executive Director and Chief Executive Officer of Nigeria's National Primary Healthcare Development Agency.
Pre-EOC, we continue to see rising cases of polio in Nigeria without ability to stop this transmission. The polio EOCs was a way to bring people together using one plan to find out where the viruses were, making sure that before the viruses spread, they were able to control it with vaccination efforts. In an EOC, you have experts of that specific disease entity that you are trying to control or to eradicate. You also have partners looking at the disease surveillance data, analyzing the data, asking tough questions. You also have health workers and community members, people who have a lot of experience in social mobilization. They are involved to also engage with local leaders, religious leaders, who are very important in conveying the information to community members. The Global Polio Eradication Initiative provided support to mobilize the financial, human, and technical resources that were required. Because of the rigorousness of how an EOC works, people have to innovate. During the 2014 Ebola crisis, we just replicated exactly what we're doing with the polio eradication program at the EOCs. The same officers that were used to do polio contact tracing made sure that the cases of Ebola were detected quite quickly before they spread in the communities. Because we had the polio EOCs in Nigeria, we were able to quickly control the outbreak. Polio eradication is a massive supply chain effort, from getting the vaccines at the national level and ensuring that vaccines actually reach kids. It is this same logistic effort that is being used for COVID-19 to make sure that all of the materials that are required in the front lines are actually there for health workers to use. We don't have to wait for the next pandemic to prepare. We have to make sure that the lessons that we've learned from polio eradication remain with us. We have to sustain the efforts around public health, strengthening, capacity building, and it's going to take a lot of collective efforts and making sure that the right investments are made. The EOCs are going to be very, very critical, and this is why the lessons that we've learned from them should really remain for future generations.